Okay, so now we are going to do the second problem. That is actually saying that my question is, first let me tell you the question. What is the question here? Okay, where is the stone? Okay, so this is my question. My question is saying that write a shell script that receives any number of file names. So we are receiving a file name as arguments, checks if argument is a file or a directory. So when it is a file, report the number of lines in it. Report the number of lines in it. So the scenario is, we need to write a shell script that receives any number of file names as an argument to check that whether the thing is a file or directory. So if it is a file, then we need to identify that whether it is a file or not. So if it is a file, so we need to return the number of lines present in that particular file. Present in that particular file. So this is my normal question. So I would like to, as you have seen the first one, the first programming code, how we can proceed. So now I would request some ideas that what will be the aim for this and what is the target, how we should approach for this problem. What is my approach? What will be my approach? So I would like any of you to just tell me the process. Anyone? Anyone would like to say anything?
Sir, we have to first create the text file.
Okay. Then? No more idea or nothing you people having in your mind for the problem? Okay, no issue on that. So let us check how we can proceed for that. So the thing is, or the scenario is, that we have the question that we need to write some shell script that receive any number of files names as argument to check whether if the file is argument or is a file or directory. And when it is a file, we can report the number of lines in it, right? No issue. So suppose, okay. So first we need to create a file. So how we can create a file? Anyone tell me?
Sir, using visual editor or any editor.
Okay. Just a minute. Okay, so I have created a text file here. Fine. Okay, so okay, now let us move for the thing. So I need to close this, show you the terminal. Okay, so I think my terminal screen is visible to all of you, right?
Okay. Yes, sir.
So we are trying to create a file using some cat command. Cat greater than Ari, a simple file name. We have put some data into that. Good morning, welcome to class, and we have closed it. Okay, so I will show you the process again, how we can create a file, how we can do that. So using some cat command. So suppose cat greater than Linux class. So when I am trying to create a file, the name cat greater than Linux class, I am entering. So that when I have pressed the enter in the particular scenario, cat Linux class, when I have pressed the enter here, right? So it will not showing the this particular option CSE at that Ubuntu. So means what it is indicating that I am in that particular section of the file. I am into the particular file. So I need to write some data into this particular file, right? So suppose I am trying to write any type of data, suppose A, B, C, D, E, F, and dot, dot, etc. Okay. Now we need to get out of this. We need to come out of this. So how we can come out? By just pressing Control D. By just pressing the Control D option. So if I am pressing the Control D option, it will do an auto save and a file name called Linux class. It will be created and the scenario will be there. Right. So this is a scenario that how I can create a file. Now my main target or main program is we need to write a shell script that receive any number of file names as an arguments to check if every argument is a file or directory. So when it is a file, report the number of lines in it. So first we need to create a shell script. So how to create a shell script? Suppose vi experiment1.sh. This is my shell script file name. So we are trying to create a vi experiment.sh, right? The terminal is open. Now we need to write some code here. So what is the code? What things we need to write here? So we will write the code into the text file, as that is very much smooth to write. So first I will getting out from this, going to my text file section, sharing the screen with you people. Just a minute. You can see the white line space. Now we need to write the values here. So what is the thing? What is the code? So if again I will write the code here. First, we need to pass the lines and arguments. So we need to check any false argument or not. So if the things are not false, then there will be no arguments. If the thing is false, then there will be no arguments. So we need to write that condition first. So if the equation, if the argument is not matching with any of the things, then it will be echoing no arguments, right? It will be echo no arguments. Okay, no arguments. Now, as the second part for F name in dollar star star, it will be indicating the file or matching the particular do if dollar minus F dollar minus F then dollar F name closing the bracket. Dollar F name is a regular file. So here the condition is checking whether the file is regular or not. So if it is matching with the file name, the start, then you can say that yes, this is a regular file. So if the condition is if the file is regular, then we need to count the lines. Then we need to count the lines number, so that count equal to how we can count the word WC. This is the simple WC minus L, the line numbers of that particular file name, of that particular file name, right? Okay, then echo the number of lines in the dollar F name. We are going to count that, and then the number of lines in the particular file will be printed here will be shown. Fine. Then echo the dollar count will be giving a output dollar count, right? It is the particular scenario. If it is not, then it will echoing that it is a directory file. Then it will echo that it is a directory file. So fname is a directory file. So for that, if we need to close all the scenario. So we have opened two if. So for that, we need to close two if. So this part, this is the simplest coding part. Now I am going back to the terminal. I am going to check. Just a minute. New share of the terminal. So my terminal screen is shared here. Now we need to check for the particular part and let's run the code. So here what we need to write, what the code we need to write, then we need to first run the shell programming part. So sh, this is my shell programming script to run. So what is the num? That is experiment1.sh, sh experiment1.sh, and suppose we need to put some file name. Suppose first I am putting some file name as, okay, as Chai Bhasha, as CSE. Okay, let's go for CSE. SH experiment1.sh as CSE. So what is the output? We are getting that CSE is a directory file. So first let me check that what are the files and things are present here. So I am putting the ls command here to get that what are the things are present here, right? So according to that, we have many things here present. So suppose I am going to run the code again. Suppose see whatever the things, the it must be present in any other scenario, as it is, this ls is showing this particular part CSE at that Ubuntu. Suppose I am trying to expose this ARI. So this is ARI, is a regular file. Number of lines in ARI are 2, and that is displaying the part. Right, so this is the particular scenario. And if I am trying to write more something, that is suppose exp.sh. So exp.sh, a regular file, again we are getting. Suppose we are trying to check Linux experiment.txt, it is a regular file. Fine. Suppose again I am going to check public, so it is saying it is a directory file. So by the terms, whatever the file name we are entering, according to that we are getting an output that whether the file is a directory file or a regular file. So if it is a directory file, then my question is that if it is a directory file, then there will be no number of lines need to be reported. And if it is a file, if it is a regular file, so the number of things need to be reported. As for that, when it is a regular file, it is showing that ARI is a regular file. Number of lines in ARI are 2. So we are getting the file name as well as the number of lines. So number of lines here we need to be present. When it is a file, report the number of lines in it. So what is the file name? File name is ARI, and number of lines present here, that is 2, right? So we are getting this particular scenario for this particular problem. But my question is, write a shell script that receive any number of file names as an argument, checks every argument is a file or directory, whether it is a file, report the number of lines in it. Report the numbers of line in it. So this is the simplest way to cover it, to get it as the result. Now again, the same process as you need to write it into the copy. So what is the problem? First write the problem statement. This is the problem statement, that write a shell script that receives any number of files name as arguments to check every argument is a file or directory or not. When it is a file, report the number of lines in it. Write it, write the question. Write the question, and when you have write the question completed, then tell me.
Hello, sir. Hello. Hello.
Yes, Rehan, say.
Sir, I am saying that you said array is a file name, and what you said about 2, sir? I can't heard that.
2 is the line number. Okay, so let me show you the file. So it will be better to understand. Okay, just a minute. So it will be very better to understand. Okay. So I think it is visible. Okay, fine. So let us check the file. Let me close it first. Okay. So I think you can see the file tab, right? You can see the file tab, and here you can see a file name that is array, right?
Yes, sir.
Now I am opening the file and I am showing you the what is the value present in that. So if you are getting the file, so you can see that there are 2 lines present. Good morning, welcome to class, right? How many lines are there?
2.
Okay. Now let me edit that particular file. I am writing many more things. Okay. So now how many lines are there?
6, 7.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right. So the result should be in the output section 7.
Yes,
so
sir.
Let me run the file here again. Okay. In this particular scenario. Just a minute, why it is showing? Oh, 8. Okay, okay, okay. Can anyone tell me why it is showing 8? For your reference, I am opening the file again. So can you tell me why it is showing 8? Just a minute. I am opening the file here. Can anyone tell me why it is showing 8? I think you people will not be able to get it because the scenario is something different. Okay, now you can see the result is 7. Now I'm telling that why it is showing 7 and 8. What is the difference? Why the same things? I didn't edit anything. I didn't done anything. I didn't delete anything. But still, why the difference is there for the 7 and 8? Redux is very sensitive, right? You put an enter, right? Suppose in the particular file, I am opening the file for you. Okay. So this is my file. You can see the... it is blinking at which point we have right now in the E, right? You can see,
yes,
night. Now Linux is very sensitive, and if you don't write anything, you are putting the enter, you have put an enter here. Okay, you are writing F, fine. You can see the blinking point. Now again, you are putting an enter. Linux consider it as a line. Right. So actual, you can see that how many lines are present? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 lines are present. You can see it here. Visually, you can see 8 lines, right? But I have put an enter there. So it is considering as 9. I have put an enter after this F. So it is considering as 9. So that's where the scenario. So if you are not necessary to do anything to create anything, so it is better to not press an enter after the F. After where you have end, if you are putting an enter, that will consider as a line, and that value will be displayed into the result. But that's why in the first term, when the lines is 7, we are getting a result of 8. But as for why that is showing 8, because I have put an enter there, and that's why it is showing the result of 8, right? So that is my scenario. So now again back to the terminal point. Now we are back again the terminal point. So this 7 is actually the line number, how many lines are present in my file, and what is the file name? The file name is array, right? So now for the question, I need to, as for the again previously, how the things need to be done. Okay, so this is my question. Write a shell script that receives any number of file names as arguments. Check if every argument is a file or directory. So if it is a file, report the files, report the number of lines in it. Okay, so how to do that? What is the process? Or everyone writes the question?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now again, step by step. Sorry for the interruption, a call has come. Okay, so now what is the process? So let's start with one by one the thing. So first we need to create a file. First we need to create a shell script file, right? So I have created a shell script file here. What is my shell script file name? That is, we can see here, vi exp1.sh. So we need to create a shell script file. So from where do we need to write? We need to write from this particular term, right? So vi experiment1.sh. This is the first line everyone need to write.
So that cat command, I think, is not
written, no right? Command, I have just explained that part to show how we can create a file. What are the several options we can expose? We can create a file by using vi editor. We can create a file by using nano editor. We can create a file directly from the terminal through the cat command also, right?
Sir, but the cat command is used to see the output of any text file.
Not like that. If that cat command is how you are exposing. Look, the cat, I have used your cat, then I have used the greater than file, right? I have greater than symbol. Now I will show you again what is the name here, cat Linux class. Now I am writing. It is like this. We are getting output.
Yes, sir.
So the cat command you can use in a several purpose, depending upon what, for which purpose you are using. If I am mentioning this cat greater than symbol, means I am trying to create a file.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so now I think the concept is clear, that not only by using cat we can visualize a file, we can also create a file through the cat command. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. So if you have any doubt, then do ask the question. That will very easy to help to solve your query. So now I think everyone have the answer, that cat command can not only be used to visualize a file, what is the result in that particular file, also by using this cat command we can create a file also, right? Depending on what terms you are using, cat greater than operator is helping us to create a file. Now okay, so back where we are. So we are in this particular section where we are trying to write some, create a shell script file, that is vi experiment1.sh. now second line we are trying to run. Okay, so not for that, after vi experiment1.sh, this is my shell script file have been created. Now what is in the particular scenario we need to check. So vi exp1.sh, what is the code written here? So everyone can write the code in your copy, as you will need to write it in your lab manual also. So I will like to request you all, those who have the facility to run this particular codes into their system, whether by using any virtual box or any Linux operating compiler online, anything. If you have the exposure to do it, please try it, because this lab is this Linux lab what we are actually trying to discuss. It is better if we do it in face to face in the physical classes, but because in our labs I have the facility of in all the systems of this Linux, so it will be very easy for all of you to do hands-on session here. But as it is online for the COVID pandemic, obviously, so expose if you have the facility of the virtual box or any other facility where you can run this code, so you can visualize, you can check that whether whatever I am trying to discuss, whether it is correct or not. Otherwise, how you people can see that whether it is the, whether the chat is whatever the sir is trying to tell, whether it is true or false, or he is randomly saying anything, randomly doing anything, right? So to know that, to do that, one should learn that, one should do that. So if you have the facility to do it, so before writing into the copy, try to do it one time. Okay, and if after, I don't know when the college will be open physically for all of you. So if it is possible that before the exam of this semester, if you people comes to the college and labs get started, then I will surely run this particular course, particular problems into the lab again for the better of you people. Right? So I hope all of you have write the code into the copy.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, so all of you have written the course into the copy. No issue on that. Now, after that, we have write the course. We have now we are going to execute that particular command. How to execute that particular command? What is the code? That is sh. This is my code. Actually, from this the code sh experiments1.sh the file name. So as per whatever the file name you are putting, you will be get the output. So here, two output you will need to write. One this particular you will need to execute, and another one this particular you need to execute. One for the regular file, one for the directory file. So for this, if you are exposing this one, the output will be up to this, right? And if you are writing for the second option, the output will be up to this. These two options you people need to write in your copy. Right? So all of you, I hope, have written this particular scenario, particular codes. All of you, I think. So now there will be a quick round of sessions. Some MCQ types questions I will be asking you people. And letting and to check that whether how much or how many of you are able to answer this MCQ types question, that is totally on the command base, because we are doing the practical lab, and I hope all of you are remembering what are the scenarios, what are the commands. So quickly, quick round of a session I am going to start after all of you have confirming that yes, I have write the code. So can I confirm that all of you have written their code?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So my question is, I am going to ask you the question, and yes, Apeksha.
Sir, when we create a file from cat command, and after editing, what are the shortcut to out from editing part?
Apeksha, can you repeat your question again? I have got a call.
Sir, when we create a file from cat command, then after editing the text, what are the shortcut to out from editing part?
I have got your question, Apeksha. Means I have write the particular things cat.linux.class here, and I have write some values here A, B, C, D, E, F. Now, what will be the shortcut key to coming out from that particular option, right?
Yes, sir.
It is Control plus D. We have used Control C for copy, Control X for cut, Control B for paste, right? The similar here, Control D to coming out from the cat option.
Sir, and how we get out from shell script file?
Again? Can you repeat the question?
Sir, how we get out from shell script file?
How we get out from a shell script file? So suppose this is my shell script file, vi experiment1.sh, right? I am into the vi editor. So different option, different editor having different short code to coming out of the editor. So if you are using a vi editor, as far as I have shown the thing into the vi editor, so the simplest key to getting out of the editor, first press the escape key here, because without the escape key it will not work. First press the escape button, then colon, you can see here, just look at this particular section where the thing is blinking, colon WQ, colon WQ, press enter. Okay, so the shortcut key, first you need to press the escape button, then colon WQ. This is the shortcut button to coming out from the VI editor. Any more doubts? So if not, then a quick question for all of you people, so that to check that how many of you remember the questions and answer session. Can anyone tell me what command is used to terminate a process? What command is used to terminate a process? I am giving four options. First one is PS. Second one is who, third one is grape, and fourth one is kill. So what are the commands? Which command is used to terminate the process?
Kill.
So kill.
Kill. Okay. So most of the persons are saying kill. Anyone with any other option? Okay, so I think all of you are agreeing with the process kill. So can anyone tell me, my next question is, shell, we are doing some shell programming, right? We are doing a lot of shell programming here. So shell programming or shell is the interface between two things, right? Shell is an interface between two things. One is user. This is my basic option. User is given. Shell is an interface between user and second option, you people need to tell me. I am giving the option, kernel, hardware, IO, and none of these. So shell is an interface between user and which of these options?
Kernel.
Okay. So all of you are saying it's kernel. Fine. Okay. So my next question will be for you people. What is a shell script? If I ask you, I have done so many shell script program right now. If I ask you what is a shell script, then what will be the answer of yours according to that? What is a shell script? What is
interface.
A shell? Yes, go on.
An interface between user and kernel.
An user interface between user and kernel to run any type program. Of particular, or we can say more specifically that it so is it a is particular a type program. Of programming, Linux programming. We can use the shell to function or prioritize our task. It is a command interpreter, we can say, which is working at the interface. Yes, it is a working interface between the user and the kernel. And what is the purpose of this shell script? It allows us to submit a set of commands into the kernel so that the process can be done particularly. Fine. So these two programs, these two shell script program, I should say, we have done in today's part. We have seen here, we have talked about this. So this shell script program we have done here today. What happened is not getting cancelled. Just a minute. So this particular scenario, we have talked or we have drawn this particular thing. What is happening? I don't know. As for the time, it is going to end for today. So up to this particular part, we are going to talk and discuss today, and we will going to more programming in our next classes. Okay, so in the next class,
we are going to talk, we are going to discuss. So after this, we are going to talk. Thank you all for joining into the session. We will meet again into the next class. Okay. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.